Hi, I'm Michał Pieszkała, a principal engineer at Callstack, and this is React Native Optimization in Practice, a series of short videos where we illustrate best practices for optimal React Native performance. This episode is about shrinking your Android code with R8. R8 is a built-in Android optimizer for making your native binaries smaller. Think something like Terser or tree shaking that's available with some bundlers, but for Android specifically. Here in front of me, I have a freshly initialized React Native project. So it has Android inside. And we wanna determine what's the size of our application so that we can then apply those R8 optimizations and see how big of an impact is that. Let us npm install and let's go to the how to optimize app bundle size chapter in React Native optimization guide. This is a book that we wrote at Callstack to help you learn about optimizations that you can perform in your React Native apps. So let's go to our part 3, bundling, where we focus on build time optimizations and how to analyze app bundle size. Inside, we can learn that there is this ruler tool by Spotify, and it can help us determine the size of our application. So yeah, that's fine. Let's copy this code and add that to our dependencies of the build Gradle. So let me go to build Gradle. Let's include the plugin. Is there anything else? Yeah, we need to apply the plugin in our app build Gradle. So let's do that. And there is also some extra configuration that will tell Ruler which application binary interface or architecture to set. In our case, it's ARM64, which locale, screen density, and our SDK version that we said that is the same for the project as we have for the compile SDK. Now that we have all of this set up, let's save it. We can go to Android folder and run Gradle analyze release bundle command. So we're in the Android folder, run a Gradle. Okay, and now we see that it wrote a HTML report about our app. So let's open that. And this report says that our app download size is 7.7 megabytes. And the install size, which is what ends up uncompressed on the actual device, is 21.5 megabytes. We typically care about the download size. 7.7, it's really, really small. This means that this app is actually not too big. Your apps are most likely bigger because this is bare bones React Native. Now that we know how big our application is, let's see how we can actually shrink that native Android code with R8. So we will need to go to the shrink code with R8 on Android chapter in our guide. It's a part 3 shrink code with R8. And to do that, we will need to flip this enable progword in release builds flag in our app build Gradle. So let's find app build Gradle and find the flag. It's by default, it's set to false, should be true. And is this everything? So there is some configuration that we may need if we use third-party libraries, disable some obfuscation. And yeah, there is also shrinking resources. And we wanna do that. We wanna shrink our PNG, JPEGs, and vector drawables. And to do that, we can set shrink resources to true. And we also need to make sure that minify enabled is also set. So let's go to our release build time. This is where enable forward flag is on. And we can also make it consistent so that minify enabled is turned on at the same time when we have shrinking resources. So now that we have all of that set, we can run our analyzing plugin once again and see what's the difference. So this is our previous results. And now it's actually smaller. Instead of 7.7, we have 5.5 megabytes of download size. This is considerably smaller, over 2 megabytes of the app size that sits in our Play Stores less. And instead of 21.5, we have 15 megabytes of install size. So the app is also smaller on the user devices. We can also see that in the breakdown, there is 63 components instead of 75. So R8 actually removed some of the components that we haven't used that were not necessary for our app to function. And that's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you have not only a better understanding of how to perform code optimizations and make your Android code smaller with R8, but also you can now implement this knowledge in your project so it can benefit your users. For more content like this, please follow us on your favorite social media platforms. See ya.